Welcome back to the workshop, everybody. And in my latest project, it's all about framing some photographs. Those who've seen previous videos will know that I like nothing better than reusing scrap timber or offcuts from previous projects. And in this case, I have these offcuts of Perspex, 3mm Perspex, which are quite good quality and very clear, that I have left over from a larger framing project. I also have these pieces of clear pine board, which are left over from the cabinet, which you will now see behind me and which you can see completed in an earlier video. So these are an ideal length, and I've worked out for some 5x7 framed photos, the maximum number I can get out of the Perspex I have is 9 frames. So that's going to mean cutting up these boards into 36 pieces to form 9 frames. The profile of the frames will look like this, 25mm wide by 19mm deep. There'll be a 25 degree chamfer on the front edge and a smaller 45 degree chamfer on the back with a very shallow curve on the outside edge just for a bit of decoration. The rebate here to allow for the Perspex, the mount, the photo and the backing board will be 5mm by 11mm. Now, with all of the individual pieces cut up for the frames, I'll use the planer thicknesser to dress up just one of the cut edges. That'll be the outside edge, which will take the cove and will be the most exposed in terms of smoothness. With the frame pieces cut to size, the first cut to make for the profile is the 25 degree chamfer, which will form the top edge. Thank you. Having cut the chamfers on the leading edge and the back edge of the frame pieces, the next thing to do will be to cut the small cove groove on the outside edges, and that I'll do with my smallest cove bit on the router table. Having cut all the coves now on the outside edges, the last cuts to make are for the rebate, 5mm in here and about 10.5mm up there. That provides a very clean right angle cut. And for these cuts, I'll be taking off my temporary splinter guard. And replacing the blade inset clearance for a zero clearance inset, which I've made myself. sort of with all of the frames now constructed, all that's left to do is to paint them. I've spent a good hour sanding them, which I didn't bore you with on camera. And I tend to use, for frames that will be painted black, I tend to use a flat finish paint for two reasons. One, it hides any small imperfections in the construction, but also it doesn't detract from the pictures themselves. With no shine on the frame, it's the pictures themselves that glow. And I'm painting the backs of the frames first, so there'll be no telltale edges showing when they're hanging on the walls.